All right, we're going to go ahead into the vendor type list that you have here. Again, in your vendor center, if you double click any vendor under the additional information tab, you have your in vendor type right here. Why would you use vendor type? It's kind of a way to segregate out your vendor list. As your company grows and grows, you're going to have more and more vendors, and you might want to be able to run reports and see, you know, how much do I buy from my utility vendors versus my consultant vendors. All right. So how do I set up my vendor list? My vendor type list. So I come up here to list, down to customer and vendor profile list. So it's a type of the profile list. I have my vendor type list here. And pulls up my current vendor types. Each of these, I can go ahead and run a quick report, see what transactions are created from the vendor types of consultant. Let's go ahead and look at another one. Let's say materials. Look at all those transactions that have a vendor type of materials. Okay. Now, if I want to create a new vendor type, I can come here and choose new, or always push Control N. And I can create a new vendor type. It's a free type area. All right. I can make it a sub account of another vendor type if I want to. I can make it a sub account here. I'd say OK. You can also drag and drop it just as you can in your chart of accounts or your items list. Okay. So I have this new vendor type. When I go into the vendor center, again, I can come in here and choose new type. All right, I can also run a report for, let's say, all purchases by vendor detail. And I want to modify this, filter it for all vendor types, all the way down there, all vendor types of materials. Okay, then it gives me only the purchases from vendors that have a vendor type of material. So it's a great way to segregate reports, a great way to be able to filter different reports out of your business. So why use that versus using a class? Class should be kind of the high level departments. Then you can use your vendor type to segregate out those departments. A big difference is you can run a profit and loss by class. Okay. But if you do your expenses by vendor summary, it's not going to look like a profit and loss. All right. You're not going to be able to run the consultant profit and loss for consultants and the profit and loss for our equipment and then a total. It doesn't work that way. You could run each individually, so I could run a report, profit and loss standard, modify and filter it by vendor type and say materials. Okay. So here it is right here in profit and loss for all vendor type materials. But I can't do it's side by side, materials, consultants, total, how I can do it in using the classes, okay? So I just want to make sure that's clear. However, it's a great way to filter down your business. So I can run this report, I can run the one for consultants, and I can run the one for subcontractors and export them all to Excel and merge them together. But also, too, you know, you can quickly run a report. Usually what's happening is the boss comes in and says, I want to know how much money we're spending on materials costs. That's a quick way to run that report. Okay. So that is using a vendor type and creating a new vendor type.